Hi, welcome to a video tutorial from Robojax. In this video, we are going to introduce the Digispark USB development board. This is Arduino compatible board. Let's get started with this. If you compare this Arduino Uno with Digispark, as you can see, it's about 8 to 10 times smaller than that, and it takes a little space. The size and compatibility makes it suitable for many applications. If you need fewer pins than Arduino Uno, this has 6 pins and some power reduction, this is suitable for tons of applications. Arduino Uno is based on this chip. And this one, we have a smaller chip, ATtiny85. I'm going to show you how to prepare your Arduino IDE and then do some blank tests and how to start using this. The upcoming videos, I will have a lot of projects. Make sure to subscribe so you can get updates on those. This is the board, and these are the connection for USB, which you can insert it in your computer. When you purchase it, usually it's shipped with a pin header like this. We have to solder them here. For the 3 pins, we need the header with the 3. We just cut the 3 pieces. Then we solder the pins in here. I've now soldered this pin header from here, pin 0 up to pin 5. We have 6 pins, and then we have 3 pins here. The pins are labeled here as VN, ground, and 5 volts. Then here we have a voltage regulator. The VN, you will connect it even once you program this and take it for your application. There will not be a computer or a connection. So either you will supply 5 volts via USB cable in here, or you can connect external power here. From here, you can connect up to 16 volts. The 16 volts come here, goes to this 7805 voltage regulator that regulates it to 5 volts, that supplies power to this. And also you will be able to get 5 volts at this pin. Can supply up to 500 milliamperes from this pin, not more than that, so keep that in mind. And we have here 6 digital pin that can be used, 4 analog pins, and we have SPI and I2C communication, and it can be programmed via USB very easily. We have 2 LEDs here. We have 1 power LED and 1 test LED. And here is the schematic diagram. As you can see, this is pin 0. We go pin 0, 1, 2, 3, up to 5. So pin 1 is the second pin which has connected this LED. If the status of this pin is high, the LED will turn on. So this LED is connected. So that LED is connected to pin 1, to this pin. The input pins have been also labeled here, but I will use the map. Here is a Digistamp page for this Digispark USB board. You can buy it from eBay by typing Digispark ATtiny85 or just Digispark, and you will see the option, and it is sold here for $175, and you have to wait for 50 days to get it, maybe sometimes 70 days, or you can get it from Amazon as well for $12, 5 pieces, or maybe $9, different packages, 3. Or you can get it from AliExpress. It is sold for around $8 US. It can be connected via USB. We have 6 pins, but if you're using USB, the 2 will be used for the USB, otherwise 4 will be used. And we have 8 kilobyte flash memory, which after bootloader, it will be 6 kilobytes. And we have I2C and SPI communication pins. And then we have 3 pins for pulse width modulation and 4 pins of analog. And we have LED, power LED and test LED. And here is the schematic diagram of the module. We have 2 chip. This is the 78M05. This is 5 volts voltage regulator that receives from VN and gives out 5 volts. That 5 volts is connected to everywhere that you see 5 volts, so which means they are connected. And also at this pin, we also get 5 volts and ground at the 3-pin terminal in here with this 3 pins. And then the 6 pin that we have on the board, they are labeled. These 6 pins are labeled from pin 0 to pin 5 here. And on the schematic, they have been labeled from 1 to 6. So this is pin 0 and that is pin 5. We have 1 power LED which is connected to 5 volts with a resistor. It will turn on as soon as the power is established. And the other LED will turn on when this pin 1 of the board is high. When it is high, this will be turned on so we can use for test purpose like blink or any other application that if you need this. This is already with the resistor. And for the USB, we have 3 pins. The 2 pin of this chip which are connected to pin 3 and 4 of the board. The pin 3 and pin 4 are connected via these 2 resistor and zener diodes will make the communication possible to be programmed via USB. Here are some of the specs that you might need. For example, active mode at 1 megahertz, 300 microampere, and power down mode, 0.1 microampere. You can do power down. Here are the pin outs. As you can see, the pin 1 is used for reset. If you want to reset it, pin 1. And here is the pin layout with comparing to the actual device. The 3 pin on this side, this can be connected to 6 to 16 volts shown here. And then this is a ground and this is a 5 volts out. When you connect the power here, you will get 5 volts out. And these are the pins. The pins have been labeled from this side. This is pin 0 and that is pin 5. Or if you count it as 1, that will be pin 6. But inside internally in Arduino, this is pin 0. So let's always start with 0 to 5. And here are the pins, PB0 up to PB5 here. These are the digital pin. And these 2 first pin are pulse width modulation with the second from the last. That is pulse width modulation. And if you're using analog, for analog, we have 4 pins. The last 4 pins are analog. And they're labeled as analog 0, analog 1, 2, and 3. And the order, pay attention here, that is analog 0, analog 1 is here. So analog 0 and analog 1. And then we have 2 and 3. So 2 and 3. These are the order. For SC, I2C communication, this is SDA. And 1 pin in between, the second, the third one is SCL. And if you're using SPI, these are the pin for SPI. And we have also 1 interrupt here. The pin 2 is interrupt, pin 0, pin 1, pin 2. Pin 2 is interrupt. First, click on File, Preferences. And under the preferences, we need to put this text. This is the path that it gets board information. http://digistamp.com/packages/digistamp_index.json. I will provide this in the description. So you can just copy and paste it in your URL for this board purpose and click OK. Once you are done, click on Tools, Boards, and then Board Manager. Click on Board Manager and here, wait until this all is active. And then type DG. As soon as you type DG, D-I-G-I, you will see Digistamp AVR boards. Now you see this is installed. If I click on this, you will see the remove appears. In your case, because you have not installed it, this will be installed. Click on that and it will take maybe, depending on your internet speed, 30 seconds, 1 or 2 minutes, and it will be installed. Once that is installed, then go to Tools, Boards, and then scroll down below the line somewhere at the bottom. You will see a divider and you will see Digistamp if your boards, the title and all the boards. In our case, we will select Digispark default 16.5 megahertz. Click on that, and as you can see, this have been now selected. The board is selected, and your IDE is ready to accept Digispark board. Now to run a Blink test program, go to File, Examples, Basic, and open Blink. When you open Blink, this LED built-in is for Arduino Uno and other devices, and change it to pin 1, make it 1, and LED Blink, make this 1, and make this 1. After that, click for the port. Do not worry what port is selected, and just click Upload. This is not connected. Click Upload. It compiles at first, and now here it says you have 60 seconds to upload. At this stage, insert it, and you will see the power is up, and you will see here uploading, and it, you will see done. Upload done, and as you can see, the Blink has started. If you're new to Arduino, pin mode 1, this means set the pin 1 as output inside the setup, and then whatever code we have here, this will be executed continuously. This line says digital write, make digital pin 1 and send the signal as high, and then keep it for 1 second high, so that is when it is on. Then we say make digital pin 1 low. This low, this makes it low or turns it off and keeps it for 1 second. After that, the loop continues, makes it on and off, and every time 1 second. As you can see, this is 1 second on and 1 second off. If you want to change it, let's say make it blink faster, let's make it 300 millisecond, and now let's remove it, compile the code, it says 60 second, and then once this is done, you will see now with the power that's running, it will be 1 second. Now it's started. As you can see, now it is blinking very quickly. And here is an example that this relay is being controlled by Digispark. Thank you for watching. This was how to use the Digispark development Arduino board. Please thumb up, and also don't forget to subscribe. I will have a lot of other videos for this Digispark development board.